I-40 may be open out of Albuquerque, but part of the interstate toward the Texas state line was closed again for part of the day, and that's created some confusion for holiday travelers. Action 7 News reporter Todd Unger is live in Edgewood.
Doug, open? Closed? Nobody out here could really figure it out late this morning, and with the temperatures out here staying pretty low all throughout the day, travel along I-40 has been anything but relatively safe.
Even getting to the interstate wasn't easy for most truckers and drivers. And once you were there, many were forced to slow down because of a cloud of thick fog.
I can tell you this, I've been in the desert many times, but I've never seen it like this.
I-40 reopened around 9 this morning, but then again closed eastbound out of Tucumcari towards the Texas state line for a while, leaving drivers frustrated once more.
We keep hearing that it's open, then it's closed. We heard that there was pileup.
Side roads and highways like 285 at Klein's Corners also stayed closed off through the morning as Department of Transportation crews do their best to clear what Mother Nature left behind.
You ever seen it this heavy right in here?
No, never.
We're told close to 100 were stranded at Klein's Corners overnight. In Moriarty and Edgewood, hundreds more hunkered down because of that roadblock. With another storm expected to roll through Thursday night, those on the road say they need to take this brief window and move out quickly.
Now, there's been one surprising thing that we've noticed throughout all of our coverage out here. There actually hasn't been a ton of accidents in this Edgewood, Moriarty, Klein's Corners area. A little bit further east out towards Tucumcari, there were some accidents yesterday. But over here on this side, things have been relatively calm. A lot of truckers and drivers we've talked with trying to get through before that next winter blast comes through on Thursday. Coming up tonight at 6 and 10, we will have much more on that. We're live in Edgewood. Todd Unger, KOAT Action 7 News.